Hello and welcome back. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button and watch my other videos on ECU chipping. Today, we're going to be learning how to install a PWM boost kit in a P06 ECU. This is an informational video. You cannot hold myself or our sponsor, HA Motorsports, liable for any damages done. This is just an informational video to help you in your tuning needs. As you can see, they provided a pretty nice setup of kits for me to install, and we're going to install the last one down here, PWM kit. Let's get it laid out and see how everything looks. Okay, we got the kit laid out. We got a diode, two transistors, an ECU pin, and two resistors. The main area we're going to be working in is the top left corner, with the ECU plugs oriented to the left and the ECU sticker facing you. The main area we're going to be working in right now is the R70. Let me get my pick so I can point that out for everybody. R70, R71, the Q29, which are these three big circles here, and the diode 14 right underneath it. Again, this is in the top left corner of the ECU. R70, R71, Q29, which are those three dots, and diode 14, which is right there. We have to get all those desoldered. So let's get that. Okay, so I'm trying to get this in focus for you so you can kind of see where it is in the back. And this is where you got to do your desoldering. Right around... Oh, hell, I lost it. Give me a second. Oh, right here. So right around there, the 1, 2, that's the diode. And then those three dots are the transistor. And if you see the ECU plug, they're still to the left. I just flipped the board upside down. And they're right there. It can get confusing, so make sure you constantly flip the board and look, but I put a little flux paste on there so that I can soften up the solder, and we're going to wick those out, and we'll come back and check it. Okay, so as you can see, we desoldered the joints here. I'll try and zoom in, actually, and give you a better view. Let's see. There it is. So that's the diode and the large transistor area desoldered. Let's go ahead and get the R70 and 71, I believe it is, desoldered. Okay, if you see, we have the, let's count them, 9 holes desoldered. And we'll look at them real quick. Again, the ECU plugs are to the left right now, going this way. And you have your 9 desoldered points here, which is going to be your R70 and R71, your diode, which I think is D14 right there, and your transistor right above it. So you'll see that the conformal coating doesn't look very good anymore. You'll see spots where it's like choppy, and the conformal coating is that shiny coating that's on the back here. You see right here, it's kind of burned up looking. And wherever you take out your components are going to be kind of messed up. Don't worry about that. You worry about that when you're done with your ECU. So let's get these little pieces in, see where they go, and solder them down. Okay, we got all the components installed on the board that we want to solder in. So we're going to go through them real quick. We have the Okay, we have the 4 components installed on the top left corner of the board for the PWM boost kit. And we have the D14 diode installed right here. Please note the orientation The line will match the line on the board, and there's an arrow going towards the plugs. So essentially the gray line is the line that's on the board. The transistor is right here. R70 and R71 right next to it. So we're going to flip it around and get them all soldered in. Okay, so after you install your D14, Q29, R70, and R71, and take note of the R70 and R71 colors. Red, red, brown, gold is your R70. And it looks like orange, orange, red, gold is your R71. So be aware of that. Again, be aware of the D14 strip towards the plugs and the transistor faces all like all the other ones. Okay, so that gets us done on the top left corner of the ECU. We're going to move straight across to this area now. And we're going to specifically focus. All right, let me do some adjusting here. Got a little glare because of that conformal coating. We're going to be working in the Q20 area right there. And that's where we're going to put that other transistor. So let's get that Q20 desoldered and get that piece in. Okay, so we're back and we got the Q20 in, which is right there. You want the label facing you. And that's with the ECU plugs to the left, label facing you. So all the writing is facing towards you. We got that Q20 dropped in and we're going to solder that in now. Okay, so we got the Q20 installed right there. And that completes the install of the PWM boost kit by HA Motorsports. So let's review exactly what we did. Okay, we're back. So we have the ECU oriented back into the way that we have been working on it, to the pins to the left and the label to the front facing you. Let's zoom in on the top left corner and look at the components we installed. D14, which is this diode right here, it has the gray strip. It goes towards the ECU plugs. This transistor, the tab goes towards the back, away from you, so up towards the top of the ECU. R70 and R71, just note the colors when we were installing them earlier. That'll take care of the top left corner. Let's go to the top right corner. Alright, so you see Q20 there, which was right up here. We installed Q20. Those five components install your PWM boost kit. That pin right there is for A11 on your ECU. So now you can enable the PWM boost function. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.